Hey guys, Ron White here. I got a special treat for you. Boris Konrad is in the Guinness Book of World Records for memory, for memorizing 215 names in 30 minutes. He's also one of my good friends. I've gone to Germany. I've had beers with the guy. Met him several times. He's a good friend of mine in the memory world, and I interviewed him here for you guys. I asked him questions. Number one, he's a neuroscientist. Not only is he a Guinness record holder, he's a neuroscientist. I asked him in his neuroscientist research, what's the number one most surprising thing he found out about the memory? Is there a difference between the average brain and a memory champion's brain? He answers that question. He answers the question, does he think there is such thing as a natural ability for memory? Can anyone be a memory champ? We talked about nutrition and memory. We talked about his memory books. We talked about the first memory book he read. I asked him what was his favorite memory event, the XMT, the World Memory Championships, or a memory open or something like that. I also asked him inside of a memory tournament, what is his favorite events? Numbers, speed cards, names, that kind of thing. It's a great interview with a Guinness record holder for memory and a neuroscientist. That is a crazy cool combination for memory. A neuroscientist and a Guinness record holder for memory and somebody that competes in memory tournaments and a friend of mine. If you find yourself enjoying this interview with Boris, if you could give me a thumbs up and give me a like during the interview, I would appreciate it and Boris would appreciate it and YouTube would appreciate it too. So check out this video.
Tell us who you are and your records.
Sure. I'm Boris Nikolay Konrad. I'm a four-time Guinness World Record holder for memory, including memorizing the most names and faces in a given period of time. But also I'm a neuroscientist, a postdoc at one of the largest memory research facilities in the world, actually.
So you're a neuroscientist and a Guinness record holder. And I asked you earlier, I said, tell us something that is the most shocking that you've discovered in your research for the brain. And what was it that you said?
The answer is it's actually no finding that's the most shocking. If I look at the brains of memory champions, like competing here in this event, and compare them to an average brain, I don't find any structural differences. It just looks the same. And that's quite surprising because there's a famous study where they looked into the brains of London taxi drivers and find out a specific part of their brain, namely the hippocampus, is enlarged due to all their focusing on learning of the map of London. And we thought, well, the memorists can memorize so much more, we must find something there. But we didn't. Because it's not about growing your brain when you do memory training, it's about learning techniques that enable you to use other memory systems and other brain regions while you learn something.
So these London taxi cab drivers, what part of the brain was it that was extra large?
It's a specific part of the so-called hippocampus, an inner brain region that's well known for map learning and spatial navigation, and that's what they focus on. Since they only have this one task, the brain region grows in this specific part.
Because it was focusing on one specific task over
focusing
and over.
Focusing specifically on learning the map of London, exactly.
So do you think there is any... Some people are naturally better at memory, though. I mean, wouldn't you say that? Or would you say there is no naturally better?
I would not say there's none, but I think it's really little. If you find some memory athletes and ask them, how can you do that? Is it your talent? They will all say, no, well, I trained for that, and I train a lot maybe, and I learned specific techniques anyone can use. And then still some people end up world champions, and some people just end up really great, but not a world champion. So everyone can highly improve their memory, but not everyone can end up a world champion. I think that's a little difference in here.
Yeah, and do you think anything as far as nutrition or anything like that plays a role?
I think it plays a role. At this event, you have a lot of stress, and if you're like in a good state of mind and a good state of health, you will be better in focusing on specific tasks, bringing your best memory, your best mental performance on the spot, and nutrition might play a role. I'm not a big fan of supplements, I just am a fan of healthy eating and have a variety of dishes, and that usually gives you all the nutrition your brain needs.
What are your memory books? You have memory books.
They're in German right now, so that would be for the German audience. I hope to find a translation soon. I've got a training book called Memory Training with a World Champion that's published 2013, and I'm so excited this year, I don't know when you will put it on, but this year my second book will come out with Random House, one of the largest publishing houses in Germany, which is a pop science book about how memory works, and I'm so excited about it, I can't tell you how much.
I can tell you're excited. What was the first memory training book or course that you took?
The first good one, let me give that one, the first one I really read was crap. The first good one was by Günter Karsten, a former world memory champion and German memory champion, who wrote a book called Successful Memory in German. And that's what I picked up when I just left school and wanted to be a lazy student, not spend so much time on learning.
What is your favorite memory event?
It's the XMT. It's Extreme Memory Tournament. It's fast. It's one-on-one. It's just amazing.
In that, is do you like numbers the best, cards, or?
Well, personally, I like names the best because I think it's most down-to-earth. It's most what everyone has to deal with. If you're working with clients, every day you meet people and you want to remember their name. Therefore, I really love this event and I'm so proud of my Guinness World Record for memorizing 215 names to the matching faces in just a quarter of an hour.
You memorized 215 different people?
215 different names.
Names, so first and
first
last.
First and last name counts too.
Okay. And real quick, last question. What's the best tip for remembering names?
Imagining. Make up images connected with the people. Have an image in your mind. See the people doing something. It's all about imagination.
So if the name is Ron, what's your picture for that?
I might think of Ron from Harry Potter and see you on a broomstick chasing a Quidditch ball.
Okay. Well, hey, man, you've always been a personal hero of mine. I have a tremendous amount of respect for you. And so I am honored to interview you. Thank you very much.